Yes, good morning to all of you, Nana. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is kinetic theory of gases. KTG, kinetic theory of gases. Okay, listen carefully. See, students, as we have discussed in the chapter, heat chapter, we discussed that if you give some heat energy to the gases or any substance, solids or liquids or gases, what will happen? They will expand. No? Clear? And if you apply some pressure on solids and liquids, what will happen? Their volume may changes. But if you see in comparison to liquids and solids, expansion or compression will be more in gases. No? Yes. Very small amount of pressure can apply, can change more volume in gases. Yes or no? Clear? That means, if you want to discuss about the condition of a gas, we need to know pressure, we need to know pressure, comma, temperature and volume of gas are required. For what reason? To specify the condition of the gas. Okay, these three are we required. What we required? Pressure, volume, and temperature. These three are main essential factors to discuss about the condition of the gas, Nana. Clear? See, this pressure, volume, and temperature, they will be interrelated to each other. Okay. Now, if we study the relation between pressure and volume, or pressure and temperature, or temperature and volume, between any two, by keeping other constant, then that study, then we are calling them as a gas laws. Okay. Now, to study the nature of the gases, we are having three laws, Nana. Losses that we are having, that is a gas loss. Okay, gas loss are nothing but study of relation between pressure, temperature, and volume of a gas. Okay, so first law, let us take Boyle's law. Boyle's law. Boyle's law, what it states? Boyle's law is stated at constant temperature. Temperature is constant. If we keep temperature constant, then pressure of a gas is inversely proportional to volume. This is Boyle's law. So Boyle's law states that when temperature of a given mass of a gas remains constant, then pressure will be inversely proportional to volume of a gas, or volume will be inversely proportional to pressure of a gas. Okay? Or volume will be inversely proportional to pressure of a gas. Means if pressure is more, volume will be less. Okay? And volume is more, then pressure will be less. This relation between pressure and volume, when temperature is remaining constant, this law is called as study of relation between pressure and volume when temperature is constant. That is called as Boyle's law. Clear? And from this, we can say P into V should be equal to constant. Okay? That means, if you take initial conditions and final conditions, these two always constant. Okay, this is very important relation. You need to remember this formula. However, in chemistry already we have discussed. Okay, P1 V1 will be equal to P2 V2. Initial pressure into initial volume should be equal to final pressure into final volume. When temperature is constant, this is called as Boyle's law. Just remember this Boyle's law. Okay, and now, after this, if you take indicator diagram between pressure and volume, if you take indicator diagram between pressure and volume, see here, I'm taking one pressure on x-axis and volume on y-axis. Let us take, okay? Now, let us do one thing. Let us study the relation between one gas you consider, okay? Now for that gas, how pressure and volume are changing? let us do this one theoretically and practically. Okay, now if you take relation between pressure and volume theoretically, you will get one graph between these two. When temperature is constant, you will get graph will be like this. You will get like this, Nana. Whereas practically, if you take, the graph will be like this. Okay, this graph, if you take at a temperature T1, okay. Now at other temperature, at another temperature, constant temperature, again if you take the graph, that time you will get the graph like this. Means these dotted lines, whatever I am showing you, this indicates theoretical values, okay. And this thick line, whatever I am drawing, this indicates practical observation between pressure and volume of a gas, okay. And this is, it is performed at temperature T2. Now see, if you observe these graphs carefully, these dotted lines means theoretical value and thick line, nothing but practical observations, they are in close agreement. See here, these two are in close agreement when pressure is less. When pressure is very less, they are coming very closer to each other, correct? That means this Boyle's law, that means we can say a real gas or a perfect gas, obeys Boyle's law at low pressure. And see, what about temperatures? Temperature also, you see, check here temperature T1 gap is more, whereas in temperature T2 gap is less, means high temperature. Here T2 is greater than T1, no? That means all gases does not obey, means gases does not obey Boyle's law at all temperature and pressure. At one particular condition only gases obeys Boyle's law, that is at low pressure and high temperature gases obeys Boyle's law. Okay, you can say perfect gas or gas, any gas obeys Boyle's law at low pressure and high temperature. You need to remember this point, important point. Okay, this point is important, you need to remember this. Clear, students? Clear. This is about Boyle's law. Okay, now see, this Boyle's law still we can write in another format also. I'll show you here. This one, understood, all of you? Clear? Anything, any doubt here in this chapter, in this point, Boyle's law? Nothing, because already we have discussed everything, correct? Okay, now see, students. For example, now second law, gas law, second law, let us take that is called as Chorley's law. And this Chorley's law, second law, we are taking Chorley's law. This Chorley's law we will take at a constant pressure. Okay, at constant pressure. At constant pressure, now we will study the relation between temperature and volume. According to Chorley's law, at constant pressure, volume of given mass of a gas is directly proportional to temperature. Means if your temperature of a gas increases by keeping the volume of pressure of a gas constant, then volume of a gas also increases. Okay, temperature increases means volume also increases when pressure remains constant. Then this is called as Chorley's law. Study of relation between pressure and volume, sorry, temperature and volume when pressure remains constant. That is called as what? Here, that is called as Chorley's law. Okay, that means if you take v by t, v, sorry, v by t is constant, ratio between volume of given mass of a gas and temperature always remains constant. Now this equation we can write v1 by t1 should be equal to v2 by t2, a relation between volume and temperature at different conditions. You need to remember this formula. Okay, na? This is called as Charles law. That means if we draw a indicator diagram between volume and temperature, volume and temperature, when pressure is constant, the graph line should be like this. That means this line indicates what, Nana? When temperature increases, volume also increases. Okay, clear? And theoretical value, graph will be like this. This dotted line indicates theoretical value. Who is that fellow who has written? Erase this. It is not erasing for me. Erase this. Who is that fellow? Who has written? Okay, now this dotted line indicates theoretical value. And this thick line indicates practical value. This means theoretical value and practical value are in close agreement when temperature is high. Means for higher temperature, see here graph, this graph, when temperature is very large, then these are coming very close to each other. Means gases obey Charles law at high temperature again. However, pressure is kept constant. Okay, this you need to remember. Gas laws are valid at high temperature and low pressure. Okay, this is about Charles law. Now, third law, let us take. There is called as Charles law at constant volume, or you can say it as Gay-Lussac law. Means according to this law, when you keep volume as constant, now you study the relation between pressure and temperature of a gas, then it is called as gas law. Gay-Lussac law. Okay, that means when volume of given mass of a gas remains constant, then pressure is directly proportional to temperature. If you increase the temperature of a gas, pressure of a gas also increases. If you decrease the temperature of a gas, pressure of the gas also decreases. When you keep the volume constant. Now, if you take the ratio between pressure and temperature, this will be always constant. That means P1 by T1 should be equal to P2 by T2. Okay. This is one law according to Gay-Lussac law. P1 by T1 always should be equal to P2 by T2. Now, if you take indicator diagram between pressure and volume, pressure and temperature. If you take the indicator diagram, the graph will go straight line passing through the origin. This indicates pressure and temperature are in directly proportional to each other. Okay, means if temperature of a gas increases, pressure of a gas also increases. Okay, this is called as Gay-Lussac law. Clear, students? Okay, now let us derive one important derivation, that is ideal gas or perfect gas. What is ideal gas? Ideal gas is nothing but a gas in which, already we have discussed this point, there is no intermolecular attraction. That gas is called as ideal gas or perfect gas. Okay, clear? This ideal gas or perfect gas obeys all gas laws at all temperatures and pressure. But if you take a real gases does not obey this Boyle's law, Charles' law, Gay-Lussac law, all temperature and pressure. Real gases obeys Boyle's law, Charles' law, Gay-Lussac law at high temperature and low pressure only. Remember this point. We will come back to this. Why they will obey at high temperature and low pressure only? We will come back to this point again when we are discussing about kinetic theory of gases. Points, assumptions, when we are discussing about the assumptions, that time I will come back to this point. Just remember, real gas obeys gas laws at high temperature and pressure only. But ideal gas, at all temperature and pressure, it will obey gas laws. Which gas laws? Boyle's law, Charles' law, Gay-Lussac law, Avogadro law, these laws. All laws will be obeyed at all temperature and all pressure by ideal gases. Okay. Now, for this ideal gas, we need to derive an equation. Okay. Derivation of ideal gas equation. Let us derive this, and it is an important derivation. Let us consider a gas whose initial conditions of a gas I am taking at P1, V1, T1. This is the initial state. This is what, Nana? Let us consider this is the initial state of a gas. Let us consider. Okay. Now, let us increase the pressure, volume and temperature from P1, V1, T1 to final pressure P2, final volume V2 and final temperature T2. Let us do this thing. Okay. So for doing this one, I'll go in two steps. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Now, let us increase. See, for example, I am having one gas. Let us imagine I am having a gas whose initial pressure is P1, initial volume is V1, and initial temperature is T1. Okay. Now for this, what I am going to do is, I'll keep temperature constant. By keeping the temperature constant, okay, increase the pressure P1 to P2. Then what happened, Nana? Volume will change. Correct what I'm saying? Yes, there is nothing but it is a Boyle's law. Okay, let us apply Boyle's law. By keeping temperature constant, if a pressure of a gas increases from P1 to P2, then what happened, Nana? Then volume of gas changes. Yes or no? Let us imagine V dash changes. Then what is that V dash? Let us find. According to Boyle's law, we know P1 V1 should be equal to P2 V2. Why? Because temperature remains constant at that time. So initial pressure is P1 only. Initial volume is V1 only. But final pressure is P2. Final volume is V dash. correct? Now, what is this V dash, Nana? V dash is nothing but P1 V1 by P2, correct?
Yes.
Now, okay, this is V dash. Now, from this V dash, now we came to the gas whose we came to the state whose volume is V dash, comma, pressure is P2, but temperature is still at T1 only. Now, let us increase the temperature of the gas. Let us increase the temperature of the gas to T2. Okay, by keeping pressure constant. If we keep the pressure constant, what we call that law? We call that law as Chorley's law. Okay. Now, if we keep the pressure constant, if we increase the temperature of the gas, then volume of the gas will change. Okay. Now, volume of gas changes to V2. From where to where? From V dash to V2. It is changing. Why? Because temperature is increasing. Then volume also increases when pressure is remains constant. Now, according to Chorley's law, what we can say? V1 by T1 should be equal to V2 by T2. Correct?
Yes.
Now, what is V1 value now? Here, from this state we are taking, V1 is V dash. Okay? And T1 is T1 only. And P1 is P2. Here P2 is not there, not required. Okay? Now, and what about V2? What is V2? V2 is V2 we are changing. And temperature we are changing to T2. It will become, I'll write down, why it is not moving? Okay. Now, let us apply this condition here. What you will get, Nana? P1 value is V dash, T1 value is T1. Should be equal to V2 value is V2, T2 value is T2. That means V dash is equal to V2 by T2 into T1. Okay. Yes. This you take one equation. Equation number two. Okay. Now. So let us go to first condition of Boyle's law. This one. This one. First equation. Substitute in first equation this condition. Okay. Yes. I'll write here. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Let us substitute this. What we will get? See, we are having P1 V1 is equal to P2 into V dash. So P1 V1 is equal to P2 into, what is V dash, Nana? V dash is V2 by T2 into T1. That means we can say P1 V1 by T1 should be equal to P2 V2 by T2. That means PV by T is constant. Correct? Yes. This is ideal gas equation. Okay. This equation we have derived for one mole of a gas. Okay. To remove this constant, we have to keep one constant term that is called as R. Here, this R is called as R is called as gas constant, universal gas constant. Universal gas constant. Clear? Now, for 1 mole of a gas, see where to write. Place is not there. Wait, no, it is not responding. Can you see, students, clearly? This Zoom app is asking update. It is not closing. I think so. It is struck. No? Wait. Update. It has came like this. Wait, students, here one window has opened. Running out of time, this meeting will end in 10 minutes. But it is not closing. If it close, I can do something. I am unable to write anything. Wait, what to do for this? Why it is not closing? I'm unable to see your messages also. This message also, it is not opening. It is showing here, the running out of time, this message will end in 10 minutes. Upgrade now to remove the 40 minutes time limit. I am clicking on update also, upgrade also, but it is not taking. I think so, it is struck there. Just send me message whether you are able to hear me or not. One message to my WhatsApp number. Okay, sir. Alt escape. Alt escape. Oh. But it is not closing, Ramit. I have pressed Alt escape, but it is not closing. It is going back to Zoom app. It is not escaping. I think so. It is struck. Initial. Alt F4. No. Ayyo. Gone. Everything gone. Hey. Shit. Came back. Huh? But it is not going. This meeting time upgrade, it is not going. Time waste unnecessarily. Sir, ADB refresh karo, sir. ADB means? What is the meaning of ADB, Nana? Ab refresh karo. Alt escape. No, I am not able to. Lalit, stop screen sharing. I am not able to press anything from this. Downside Zoom app logo is there, no sir. There two or more windows are started. Try to close extra. Yes, good, good, Nishal. I think so. Who is this? I don't know. Okay, let it be. Yes, it came. Can you hear me now? Struck again. Good, Vaibhav. But it is not. I'm not able to write on this again still. Cross mark, nothing is here. No, I am not able to. Miss, it is not taking anything, Nana. Only the thing is, I have to go to that meeting. Now it has gone, Nishal. Now it has gone, huh? Yes, time up, Nana. That remaining part, 1-2 points are there that I'll write and I will send that JPG to you after my class. Control, Shift and Escape. Control, Shift and Escape. Nothing is came. Sanjeev, don't write on that. Yes, June. Yes, it is structured, Nana. I think so. Okay, students, you join in a mass class at 12 o'clock. Okay. I buy to unnecessarily waste time here. Some students be here only. Nishal, Vaibhav, and Abhay. Let us do this. What happened for this? Now it is coming. Stop. I'll stop sharing. Yes. Now came. Correct? Yes. Okay, students. We'll continue in next class. I think so. How many students are there? 30 students are there. Master, send your. Okay. I'll write that points and I'll send you. Okay. Yes, came. Once you listen here, 30 students are there. Okay. Now, let us come back to that point. Where, yes. R is what? A universal gas constant. Now, for 1 mole of a gas, this is for 1 mole of a gas. Now for n moles of a gas, it can be written as PV by T is equal to NR. Okay. And this equation will become PV is equal to NRT. This is ideal gas equation. Important. You need to remember this ideal gas equation. Okay. Derivation read from your material. Okay. Here I have given you proper idea how to derive this one. Okay. Na? Clear? Here R is universal gas constant. Na? Now I think so. Students are there. Yes. Let us continue this class. Yes, whatever the derivation easy for you, that you follow, Nana. I think so. It is only easy for you. See, from material, it is very easy. Okay.